Good morning to one and all. I am Christy. I am going to take the topic examination of gunshot residue. Can you move to the next slide, please? So these are the topics that I am going to discuss today. Composition of propellants and primers, collection of GSR, chemical tests that are used for identification of GSR, instrumental analysis and conclusion. Now, whenever we deal with GSR, we have to learn about what goes into the ammunition. Basic composition of the ammunition is the cartridge, which could be brass or nickel. It can be rimmed or rimless. Now, second one is primer, which is a sort of a button which is fixed into the back of the cartridge. Primer has a sensitive explosive, and there is powder or propellant that fills inside the cartridge, and the bullet is pressed fit inside the cartridge. Now, when we come to the constituents of the primer, major primer elements are lead, which is primer explosive, that is lead stiffness. And when the firing pin strikes the primer, it causes the lead stiffness to ignite. This releases the oxygen for the barium nitrate, which is the second component of the primer, and then this oxygen goes to antimony, which is in the reduced form, antimony sulfide. Thus, the nitrate burns the antimony. So, these are the three elements of the primer. Now, these will be the three elements or identity we look for during the GSR examination. Because all the propellants or the explosive does not burn all together, we will have some traces of explosives left below. Now, types of propellant or gunpowder. There are three types of propellants, that is black powder, smokeless powder and semi-smokeless powder. Now, black powder is a combination of potassium nitrate, sulfur and charcoal. In smokeless powder, there is three types, that is depending on the base, single base, double base and triple base. Single base contains nitrocellulose, and in double base, it is a combination of nitrocellulose and nitroglycerin. In triple base, it is nitrocellulose, nitroglycerin and nitroguanidine. In semi-smokeless powder, it is a mixture of black powder and nitrocellulose. Now we'll discuss about collection of gunshot residue. First one is dry method. In this collection of GSR is from the hand. In this method, the molten wax of suitable melting point is generally brushed over hand with 1 to 2 millimeter thickness. After it is set up, it is peeled off. As a result, it picks up the GSR from the hand. In cellulose acetate, a solution of cellulose acetate is applied on the site where it bears this GSR. After drying, it is also peeled off, and the removed cast will pick up all the GSR on the site, from the site. In cellophane sheets, it is soaked in acetic acid, which is pressed against the site. This will also pick up the lead that is left in the hand or the site. By using adhesive tape also, we can pick up the GSR from the site. In this, inert adhesive tapes are used to press against the site bearing the GSR. Further, tape is kept in a vial with adhesive surface inside the vial. Next is wet method. Sorry, ma'am, previous slide. Here, using the filter paper, we can collect the GSR. Dilute acetic acid is sprayed on the filter paper, which is pressed against the suspected spot. Here, the GSR can be picked up by the filter paper. Or a cotton swab can be used, which is moistened with the dilute acetic HCl or nitric acid, and it is swabbed on the suspected area. The swab from this different parts of the hand can be collected and it is packed separately. Dilute nitric acid can be used for collecting the GFR by washing the hands of the suspected hands, and it can be collected in plastic bags. Collection of organic residues can be done by swabbing, tape lifting, and vacuum lifting. Vacuum lifting is commonly done in cloth so that the residues present on the cloth can be picked up. Can you move to the next slide? Now, these are the chemical tests that are used for the identification of GFR. First one is Walker test for nitrate. Here, the piece of filter paper is moistened with acetic acid, which is pressed against the target surface. The filter paper is later sprayed with a solution of 2-naphthalamine 4-8 disulfonic acid. If the bright red color is present, or bright red color is formed, we can say that the nitric particles in the GFR are present on the suspected area. Next is Harrison and Gilroy reagent. Here, the cotton swab, which is moistened with 0.1 N HCl, is applied on the sweeper's back of the thumb, trigger finger, and web of the palm, because these are the strongest areas where the concentration of GFR is found. And after that, we add triphenylmethyl arsenic iodine solution. If there are formation of orange color or orange ring, we can say that antimony is present on the suspected area. Now, sodium rhodophanate test. Here, the filter paper or photographic paper is used. It is pressed over the bullet hole slightly, which is moistened with 0.1 normality HCl. Later, it can be dried using the hot air blower, and carefully it is coated with saturated sodium rhodophanate solution in water. After that, filter paper eventually takes the orange color from the sodium rhodophanate, and filter paper is warmed again but not dried. Solution of naphthalene, ethylene, diamine hydrochloride in methane is used, and here, the same as Walker test, orange color is present. Purple color is formed if lead is present. Next is grease. Ma'am, previous slide, please. Grease test here, it is same as Walker test. Here, the solution used is naphthalene. Instead of 2-naphthalamine 4-8 disulfonic acid, which is used in Walker test, and the color obtained here is orange color if there is a presence of nitrate. Tiwari test here, andosulfan hydrochloride and water is mixed. After that, HCl is added until the white precipitate is dissolved. A filter paper is moistened with acetone and pressed against the target surface, and after that it is dried. After that, andosulfan solution is sprayed, which results in the deep yellow spot, which indicates the nitrate compound. The last one is Marshall test. Here also, photographic paper is soaked with 0.5% of sulfonic acid. It is dried, and then after that, N-alpha naphthalene ethylene diamine hydrochloride in methane is sprayed. After drying, just like Walker's test, orange color is obtained. Next slide, please. Now, these are the instrumental analysis of GFR. First one is Scanning Electron Microscope, EDX, Electron Dispersive X-ray. This is used to detect the electrons generated by two different processes, and X-ray is used for the compositional analysis. This is the combination of two microscopes. Here, it is the non-destructive method, and it provides. It is commonly used for the examination of GFR because it has high resolution and magnification. In this working is when a beam of primary electron collides with the specimen, some electrons are reflected back. An image thus obtained showed the 3D image of the particle. The primary electron beam which hits the specimen produced, ma'am, next slide please, the ionized atoms due to the force of the emitted electron. These specimen electrons emitted from the sample is called the secondary electrons. Further generated X-rays which are used to find out the elementary compositional of the particle. Next slide please. Second one is X-ray microfluorescence. This technique can be used to reveal the presence of lead and other metallic particles which are deposited on the suspected area. And the third one is infrared rays photograph. This method is commonly used in colored cores so that we get, it helps to reveal the pattern of GSR on the colored floor. Coming to the conclusion, GSR can be used for examination of GSR can be done to determine if the firearm is used or not, to determine if the person was present on the crime scene or not, to estimate the firing distances, if a wound is present, if that wound is caused due to the firearm, or if a hole is present on the clothes, wall, or guns, or on the furniture, if to find out if those are formed due to the gunshot or not. These things can be determined by examination of GSR. Also, in indoor crimes, when the room is closed or closed crime scene, if we get more GSR when compared to outdoor crime scene. So this is all about the examination of GSR. Thank you.